Parental discretion is advised.
Find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh? Check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you. Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show 504. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitters here in Pittsburgh, PA, at the wonderful, luxurious Mayhem Studios, ready to talk professional wrestling with my friends, my colleagues, my compatriots, my compatriandes. Sorry, Garza. With me, back on the line, first of all, from Poughkeepsie, New York, the only one this week that has a future endeavor letter from the WWE. He is Mad Mike.
Hi, Sorg. How are you today?
Hi, Mike. How you doing?
I'm good. I'm fresh from work. I came in just under the wire, but I'm ready to mayhem.
Mm-hmm. Ready to mayhem. Also ready to mayhem. He's going to mayhem hard with parts of his body, probably. Papa Lunchbox, DJ Lunchbox, the proprietor of Panel Riot Podcast on your podcast thing.
That's good alliteration. I like that a bunch. Proprietor of I can't remember it now. It's real good, and I'm real happy to be here. Hi, everybody. What's happening?
Hello, and also coming at us, he is hyped. He remains hyped. He will stay hyped. He is endeavored to be hype. He is the Riz. Why are you hype?
Because, Sorg, you gave me this shirt that – Can I stand up for this, Sorg?
Yeah, sure. I guess so. Your mic's on your face, so what would I get the top of your head?
It's not really on my face.
What's happening?
I will be right back.
I'm going to
show you why I'm so hyped.
All right, he's standing up, so I'm going to explain this.
This is the point where Riz whips his dick
out. he's taking
part,
his pants off,
the audio
and he's got a wonderful
listeners.
4X steak.
That is my knee.
No, that's your crotch. That is your
that
knee?
Is your chest.
That is how long the shirt is.
There's a t-shirt of Mojo Rawley that I won in a tournament.
Stay hyped.
For at the 10th year anniversary for the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
There he goes. And now there's his forehead. So he has been tasked.
I've been hyponized.
He's been hyponized. He is tasked to stay hype with us in that wonderful 4X shirt that makes
Sorg has forced me to wear this wherever I go. Whenever he's around.
This is right. If I see Riz has to be hyped. Yes.
I'm always hyped, Sorg.
Yeah, of course.
He doesn't
of
get
course
hyped.
You are.
He stays
I'm
hyped.
Not doubting your hypeness. Not absolutely not.
You sound like you're doubting my hype.
I don't know. I'm starting to.
Am I not the one who sold a Raven versus Disco Inferno DVD the first night of WWE.
I really hope that DVD worked for that person because that was from old stock and it was really
too,
questionable.
That was he paid full price for that.
Oh no. I if we find that person, I'm gonna give him a free digital download just on principle. I feel so bad. We found problems with the old stock, but we have the good stuff over at indiewrestling.us. Also with us from I almost said Sacramento, that's not right. San Antonio, Texas.
California.
I got California on the mind today. I'm sorry. Eamon Payton, the voice of Inspire Pro Wrestling out of Austin, but he's in San Antonio. How you doing, good sir?
Yeah, I'm making a long trip from Sacramento to Austin for these shows.
There you go.
terrible joke. I'm sorry. I'm excited to be back on. Excited to talk about wrestling because wrestling happened a lot this week.
That's right. And also with us, our awesome chat room, Bobby FJ Town's in there. Wheels is in there. Heel Garza is in there. Our wonderful Patreon, but we get to that in a moment. You can check us out. We're at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can subscribe to this and all the other shows on your iTunes, iHeartRadio, Spreaker, Stitcher, and now streaming live on the 405media.com. Actually, we've been there for a while. I figured we should probably talk about those guys because they've been really awesome to us. We're right there beside all this Donald Trump coverage, so you got everything that you want in the world at the 405media.com. Check them out. Thank you so much.
WWE Hall of Famer Donald Trump.
Thank you so much for WWE Hall of Famer Donald Trump. There you go.
I will throw every Mexican out of the Royal Rumble.
Yes, we're paying attention. Okay. But no, they've been really awesome. They've been carrying us for a good while. And I feel like I haven't been giving them enough love, so I want to give them some shout-outs here. And probably will lead to some off-color political jokes. So, hi, guys. And we're streaming there. And thank you, everybody, that's listening to us on there as well. Also, drop us a line with your complaints and comments from everything we just said at 412-206-WMS0 and goodtimes@WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. And hook us up with fan mail. Let us know what you think about the pro wrestling stories we need to talk about. Who should we have on the show? Are there other podcasts or other wrestling personalities? Who should it be? And also, because I have to cough right now, DJ Lunchbox, tell them about the Patreon, please.
Well, Sorg, I'll tell you what. The Patreon sure is a great system that they set up so that we can have money. You, the listener, can support our podcast, put your money where our mouths are. You just head on over to WrestlingMayhemShow.com, click the link that says Patreon, and go from there. We have many excellent, excellent Patreon contributors. They are wonderful, and we love them each equally and dearly. Sorg, who are those people?
You turned my mic back on. Okay, there's a wonderful people like the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment, the WrestlingRevolution.com, our longtime Patreon supporter. Ed Burke is on there, as well as Bo Diggity. Woo! Thank you so much. Sorg, value for value. If you're enjoying the show, I've had some voice problems over the weekend. It went away. It feels like I might have to hand over the show at some point here. But if you're enjoying the show, you want to contribute to our ever-growing nation, and we had some ideas on what if we had a studio over on the Gold. What amenities would we have in that studio if we had a Wrestling Mayhem Show exclusive studio that wasn't this wonderful basement right by my laundry?
That only gave us YJ Stinger.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. He'll stay.
Well, there you go. But if you're digging it, and that's okay. If you give 50 cents, if you give a penny, if you give $5, we'd really appreciate it per episode. You can set limits for the month, whatever's convenient for you. Or just share the show. Just let other people know about this show if you think it's up their alley, and the kind of wrestling and kind of the people we're talking about. And thank you, new listeners. If there's new people tuning in, I know a lot of new eyeballs were looking at our stuff this past week with our some interesting things were said by Mr. Krista Joseph that joined us last week. And thank you for the outlets pointing out there. Thank you, friends that reached out that apparently saw my face plastered, because that my face was the default on the YouTube video that was going around instead of Mr. DeJoseph. I hate how YouTube does their thing. So I should have updated that.
But they got to see your pretty face.
Is it good? Like this guy. Like so many people know what this is now. And my Twitter account and everything like that. So anyways, let's get into the pro wrestling news and info. And it's going to be very Royal Rumble themed this week. Hey, it's on our mind. It's the big, it's a kickoff. It's the road to WrestleMania, or the HOV, the lane to WrestleMania. I was loving some of that stuff from the wrap up. Thank you guys for taking over that for me last night. It was some good stuff. But the big thing, of course, Triple H, you're new. That young upstart Triple H is your new WWE Heavyweight Champion. And
NXT,
man.
NXT Superstar Terrorizing.
NXT Superstar Terror. I wish like he like lost his memory and that actually became a storyline. first of all, I want to talk about the storyline of the Royal Rumble rather than the Royal Rumble itself, because I really want to get into some of the details based on some stuff here in segment two. But first of all, how do we feel about this idea that Triple H came in? And I feel a very Vince McMahon kind of move, except we'll get a better match. I feel like we were going to get him and Seth Rollins in some capacity anyways, personally. I don't know. I have no confirmation. But I feel like that's where the trajectory might have been. If
you mean
still
Roman Reigns, or do you mean before
I'm
the
sorry,
injury?
Seth Rollins, Triple H.
Roman, you said
Seth Rollins before the injury.
I mean Seth Rollins. Okay. I think if he didn't get injured, I think Seth Rollins, Triple H was going to happen at some point here, probably at WrestleMania, and that would be your big thing there. And of course, so much has happened since. And with the injuries and everything. How are we feeling about that, guys? LB.
I'm,
No, screw you, Eamon. LB, I want to know. LB wasn't on last week. I want to know what he thinks. Well, here were you.
I'm thrilled to pieces.
Okay.
I think it's fine. Who gives a shit what Triple H does in the main event or at the end of the Royal Rumble? What he did, him coming out, him competing, had no effect on what every other wrestler did in that match. They all put on really excellent, really great performances. Honestly, a lot of people were pitching a fit about, you know, Triple H and Roman and all that bullshit. The most upsetting part of the Rumble to me was that Kofi didn't do much.
True.
He got eliminated off camera after getting caught by Big E, and that was that. You know, that was a bit of a bummer for me. But aside from that, I thought it was a really good Rumble match. I really enjoyed myself, and honestly, I don't understand why people were talking about this. You should talk about AJ Styles. Are you fucking kidding me? AJ Styles showed up and was there for more than 10 seconds. Come on now.
Oh, I am upset about something about some dirt sheets out there and talking about AJ Styles.
No,
that's a whole different story. But
okay.
Go ahead, Eamon.
I was just going to say, my thing was that people kind of defaulted to the whole, oh, Triple H is burying people. I saw the GIF of, you know, Triple H in the shuffle all around the place. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Stay hyped. But here's the thing. Like, if we want to actually look at it in the context of the Rumble, like, who did he really bury? Who do you bury? Dolph Ziggler? That lost cause, Dolph Ziggler? Like, who cares?
He's the entire match buried.
I really hope that's his new nickname, the lost cause, Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah, like, did he bury Sheamus? You think the last 3 months haven't done that enough? Like,
he didn't even bury Dean Ambrose. Dean Ambrose, actually, I think, I didn't mean to cut you off, Eamon.
No, go ahead.
But I think I'm about to say your point. Dean Ambrose excelled when Triple H was there. He put that to another level, and he was the last two in there. And for a little split second, I actually thought Dean Ambrose was going to be a double champion.
Yeah, it was a smart final too.
Mm-hmm.
But like the important young talent that of the WWE didn't get buried because their stuff that they did in the match was amazing. You know, your Kevin Owens's, your Sami Zayn's, your Neville's. I said, but yeah, your Neville's.
He didn't do much.
But you're AJ Styles. He's not young, but he's new. You know, those guys got to do stuff and be cool and awesome. And, you know, and I thought it was good. Mm-hmm. Your Braun Strowman's getting to eliminate, you know.
Oh, that was all the crazy.
Kane and Big Show.
Yeah.
Compare that to last year when Kane and Big Show were eliminating all the young talent easily. Yeah.
I think that was a huge statement. For that, you know, showing off that, and even just having the opportunity to say, whoa, Strowman's as big as Big Show. Like, I didn't even realize that.
I had no idea. That was incredible.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is one of those, like, remember back in the day, like, you know, I was reading some articles about how great the Rumble was, and they were, I think it was the one that was rating all the Rumbles, basically. And, you got the confrontations of guys that normally didn't mix together. And Strowman. Like the bread? Anyways, you know, like he got to mix it up with Big Show, and they had a moment because those guys haven't really been together, right? Or he's being beat down and you don't really notice. You didn't have a nose to nose with those two, right? And there was a bit of mixing, you know, just like just about anybody that AJ Styles touched was a new encounter,
mm-hmm.
which was great, right?
Like, yeah, I think the only person who in that Royal Rumble that he even came in contact with that he might have before is Goldust.
Right. And on
I think that's the
under
only
a different
person.
Name. That's it. That's absolutely it. I thought there was a lot there. There was a lot there for people. There was a lot to love for people that love the Royal Rumble, despite Triple H and the storyline. You knew in the long run. You know, the story was Roman Reigns and what Roman Reigns has been doing. And we had not seen Triple H. So he's enough out of your mind to come back and make a statement like this. And I'm with that. You know, he kind of teased a couple years ago. Well, maybe I'll win the belt, you know, with Daniel Bryan at WrestleMania 30. And then he did. and he's it's easier for him to hate because you know where he is with things, you know. And I love it. It's great. It's great stuff. I can't wait to see what they do here going into I don't want to say I'm excited for Fastlane, but into the WrestleMania.
I'm excited for Fastlane.
You're excited for Fastlane.
I think there's a way for Fastlane to work.
Okay, is this like I say, you said on the Slack today, you have a way to fix Roman Reigns. I don't think there's a problem with Roman Reigns.
I think there's a big problem with Roman Reigns.
I think he's been built up. Oh, he's got this thing going on. I know it's not as hot as like they would want it to be, but I think all things considered, I think he's doing great with everything. What do you think needs fixed with Mr. Reigns? With my buddy Roman Reigns.
Yeah, sort that's about how many dimensions Roman showed right there. what you have right there. It's one dimensional.
Believe that. Believe that.
And I mean, I can't hear you, Sork.
Believe that.
I believe he's saying
believe that. He's saying bereave that, because of the death of the career of Roman Reigns.
Oh. Breathe that? Is that what you're saying?
Believe that.
Yeah, Sork, it doesn't work. That's about as good as Roman Reigns as Mike's skills right there. But so here's the thing I think they should do. For Fastlane, we have the nonsensical triple threat matchup, which is fine. I think Dean Ambrose should win that. And I think it throws off a lot of people who are expecting Triple H versus Roman.
Okay.
It gives you a really nice pop because, I mean, Brock's going to be taken out by the Wyatt family in that match regardless to set up Brock versus Bray. And then I think you have Dean sneak a clean win on Roman. Excuse me. And then you have Dean come out the next night on Raw saying that he's really happy to be going to WrestleMania. But at the same time, he feels a little sad because he feels his brother got screwed over. Because Roman Reigns had to defend the title in the Royal Rumble, and he never got his rematch. And he calls Triple H out and says, Triple H, I know we had the match last night, but I think Roman should be added to make it a triple threat. Mm-hmm. And Hunter doesn't immediately dismiss that. He says, all right, but because you're the one asking for it, Dean, and not Roman, you're going to have to earn it. So we have like 5 weeks from Fastlane to WrestleMania. Every week, Dean Ambrose has to wrestle a member of the League of Nations in a match of Triple H's choosing. If Dean Ambrose can beat all the members of the League of Nations, Roman is entered into the main event at WrestleMania. And then you get four solid main events. You get a nice story. And at WrestleMania, like Dean Ambrose obviously, you know, wins all four matches. And then you get kind of a Shield beatdown on Triple H at some point. Like they're going at it mostly back and forth, Triple H throwing one out, you know, how you do triple threat matches. And then when it looks like they're about to take Triple H out of the match for good, Roman spears Dean by surprise and pins him. And Triple H looks shocked, and then Roman celebrates with the title. Dean goes to congratulate him. Roman powerbombs him through a table on the outside. And Roman hugs Triple H. He joined the authority, just like The Rock joined the corporation, and Dean Ambrose is the hottest face in wrestling.
Ooh.
Oh, so this is that. Well, I understand that. That's to help Dean Ambrose, though, not really Roman Reigns.
it's to help Roman Reigns, too, because Roman has two main issues. None of them are in-ring. He's not as good on the mic as they want him to be. And he's never going to be the top face with someone like John Cena around, or even Dean Ambrose, who gets a better face pop than him.
My thing with Roman being the face, I think it's absolutely possible. I think there was a period of time, you know, a few months ago where they were actually sort of doing the right job of just letting Roman be a badass and just have good matches and you know, deliver. And then I think slowly and surely the Roman hate was sort of dying. I think the Royal Rumble really showcased that they still don't have a complete understanding of how to make Roman the top babyface. Because their idea was, we're going to stack the deck against Roman, but we're going to take him out in the middle of the match. So he skips being in the ring with Big Show. He skips being in the ring with Brock Lesnar. He skips being in the ring with all the top threats in the match. And then once all those guys get eliminated, he's going to come in fresh. And they expect the crowd to cheer for him. It was one of those cases where it's like, I don't think you really understand your audience.
I think that was the worst. Garza saying, like, explain to me why he couldn't come out and fight, but even Owens dragged his ass out there, right?
Yeah, that's the thing.
I thought that was an awesome statement, because usually you have somebody beat up like that, you're like, well, he's not coming back for the Rumble. And he completely did.
I think if they had Roman in the entire match, he wouldn't have gotten as booed at the Rumble.
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Well, see, they tried to do the exact same thing that they did with Austin.
Mm-hmm.
Because the year that Austin was, like, targeted by everyone from the corporation, Austin was dragged into the women's bathroom of the arena and was beaten to a pulp and left.
I remember that. I just rewatched that, actually.
Yeah, so they tried to do it, but they have to understand, Roman Reigns is not Stone Cold Steve Austin. No matter how much they want him to be, he's just not.
No.
Austin is a blue-collar badass. Roman Reigns looks like he's chiseled from granite. Roman Reigns is closer to The Rock than he is Austin or Daniel Bryan.
Well, my thing is that also in that scenario, Austin was already made.
Yeah.
So you could have a situation like that. You know, if you're still trying to build Roman, you put him in that match in its entirety. You have him fight Brock. You have him fight Owens. You have him fight the Big Show, the Wyatt family. You have him do that. You know, to take him out of the match and then put him back in when all the threats are gone, I don't understand why, you know, you think someone would cheer for that.
I do feel like, yeah, I feel like having him be out there and kind of proving himself would have made more sense, right?
It's still in the sense of he's going an hour, basically.
Right, exactly. For him to go there and go through all that stuff, then to be screwed over at the end by Triple H, by coming out fresh, you know, and being Triple H, versus he got beat up, but he really kind of had a breather in the back, you know.
Yeah, like, and he came out not selling anything.
Yeah, to a guy that still has to prove himself and continue proving himself to fans, the critical of fans, I feel like, you know, you gave him a glorified breather, like you know, non-kayfabe, right?
And it's very simple. You just let him be a badass, you know, and eventually the crowd's going to sort of get behind him.
Like, but see, the thing is, you can let him be a badass all he wants, but if Raw sticks to the same formulaic show where the champion has to talk for 10 minutes, I don't care how much of a badass Roman Reigns is, his microphone work is going to negate all of that.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, I don't think everybody should have to talk for 10 minutes. Like, I can understand some people doing it. I don't think Roman needs to.
No,
absolutely. He can deliver a line or two and then just beat people up.
As long as that line isn't "believe that."
That's fine. I don't mind that. But, you know, there's ways of doing it and keeping it on face. I don't think having to turn on heel is the immediate, like, thing you have to do. You know what I mean?
But the only reason I'm suggesting we turn Roman heel is because after that, you get a easy feud with Roman and Dean. And then you can have them feud for 2-3 months. And then guess who's ready to come back? And guess who's going to get a huge pop when he comes back? Seth Rollins. Mm-hmm. And then you have, for SummerSlam, your Shield triple threat that they wanted to do for Mania, I think.
Right. Well, we'll see. We'll see where this goes. But either way, we got some other Rumble problems we need to deal with. And I'm excited to kind of see what you guys think of this as we go. But anyways, hey, I want to give shouts to our good friends. We've had a few people in studio here over the months here, and of course, you know, more so of course with Awesome Cast because it's more locally. But our buds, you guys have been in the studio at times and part of the show in person and partaken in our good friend Slice on Broadway right here in Pittsburgh. So definitely want to give shouts to them. They're supporting our Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. And that's not how that'll come in. There it is. So thank you so much for them. It's good stuff, good people. I was just in there getting my pizza to watch the Royal Rumble too. Gotta have some good stuff there if we want to sit down and watch one of my favorite pay per views of the year and pick something up. And they're good people, and they say, "Hey, we'll see you Tuesday." And we got a really good rapport. We've been with them for they've been with us actually for almost 2 years. Check them out. Great gourmet pizzas. I'm usually a plain pepperoni guy, but they got some good stuff right here along the tracks, Beachview, as well as go down in Carnegie, PA. Here in the south of Pittsburgh, please go check them out. SliceOnBroadway.com, at PJ_Slice on the Twitters. Let them know you heard about them on the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Follow them on the Facebook and on the Instagrams, and you'll get hungry too. All right, let's go. More Royal Rumble talk. So there's this article that one, Matt Carlins, I think, shared this on the Slack, and it kind of piqued my interest a little bit, so much that I canceled our original topic. I thought it was a fun Rumble. I thought there were a lot of surprises, you know, not so much like there weren't like AJ Styles was the surprise, but there weren't like a lot of returns. There wasn't Diesel coming back. There's not that time when Mr. Perfect came back out of nowhere, stuff like that. Right. But there was a lot
of, they have a big roster.
Yeah, they do have a big roster. They filled it pretty nicely there. To which I'm like, why did we have all these factions if we're not going to bring them all out here? Right. But I understand. But
well, they still play their part.
If you put everyone from all the factions in,
I know
that's half the Rumble.
I know. But then you forget. Oh wait, there are all these other people too. Imagine if so many people weren't hurt, what they could have done with the Rumble, right? But anyways, so there's this article from
John Cena win it.
from Figure Four Weekly. Had an article about. Five Royal Rumble rules WWE should make. And some of these, like, I've heard of people getting disqualified, by the way, on the Royal Rumble. There was one I was watching, and then they had apparently disqualified Fit Finley for using the shillelagh at one point, which surprised me, since I watched some of the late 90s ones where it turned into a hardcore match when, like, Raven would come in, right?
Yeah.
And then
the Finley one, I think that was the one we were at, Sorg.
I think it might have been.
I think they made that up because he didn't go over the top rope.
Something like that. Yeah, just like the when Macho Man eliminated himself, and it's like, well, somebody has to eliminate you. You know, things like that. That happens. But let people lose by DQ. I don't know if I completely agree with that one. I think it has to be you lose by going over the top rope.
Because I feel like if you have the DQ thing, it makes for a real cop-out scenario.
Exactly. Yep. Exactly. There's a lot of goofy things you can do there. And you got to keep the Rumble authentic, right?
Like the entire Wyatt family destroyed most of the roster.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And half of that was after three of them were eliminated.
Savio Vega entered with the entire Los Barricas team.
Yeah,
in the Rumble I just watched. Yeah, I mean that's.
Guy and Ty entered the Rumble in 2000 like five times.
Exactly, exactly.
And somehow they were eliminated six.
And, but I like this. Make the time a complete shoot. Because I don't know if anybody said.
I like that rule a lot.
I'm pissed that it isn't. I'm really pissed that it isn't. When, like, the first time I found out, like, I read an article when they broke down, like, one of those, like, you know, minute-by-minute things where they're, like, had all the eliminations and how much time things took and everything. And it was like, yeah, this one was like 45 seconds. And then this one was, like, you know, a minute something, you know? I'm with this.
I was going to say, we were saying that last night at the Rumble, or 2 nights ago at the Rumble party I was at, was when the Wyatt family was attacking Brock or whatever. I was like, this has been a long minute and a half.
Yeah, exactly. Or when they come out and stare at each other for a long time, right?
See, the thing about that is, though, I think they don't keep it a shoot because then they can allow the other matches on the card to go. You know what I mean?
Really?
Because, like,
yeah.
I think so. I think, like, let's say the Divas match went a little long.
Okay.
So, like, okay, so we can cut down the entrance time to build up to Jack Swagger and have him come out in 40 seconds instead of a minute and a half because he's not going to be in there that long anyway.
Well, the clock doesn't start when they hit the ring, too. But what that also lends to, again, on this article, once the time is up and the buzzer sounds, you have 10 seconds to get to the ring.
Or else you're disqualified.
Or else you're
disqualified. Well, no, because then you can't get cool stuff like The Miz sitting on commentary because he's intelligent.
True. That is also true.
I'm with you.
That's
not cool stuff.
That's really annoying.
So I'm with him.
That was absolute bullshit. The year that he won by hiding underneath the ring, the whole Curtis Axel shit. No. That's not
good stuff. You're getting angry over heel shit.
Mm-hmm.
That is mission accomplished.
I'm not getting angry over heel shit. I'm being annoyed by heel shit.
Mission accomplished.
Yeah.
Okay, with that. So right. I'm saying we keep number one. Let's have shoot times. We X off number two with the buzzer because then we can have curious things happen and can be a little creative with things and annoy LB another year. Yes.
I mean, Jerry Lawler did the same thing. Hmm.
You did. Oh, yeah. This has happened for years, of course. If any part of your body touches anything, including people outside the ring, you're out. No.
Fuck that noise.
No. We X that out. Because the 2 feet rule makes things interesting. Kofi's been the innovator of this. Not as great, although they did like kind of completely what I thought they would do.
What else can you have him do besides
I don't know.
Win it?
It's Kofi. It's up to him to be creative, right?
I'm just wondering why they didn't walk to the back for a while or stand in the entrance ramp.
That's true.
Well, that's what I would have really wanted was for them to be Kofi to be on Big E's shoulders until Big E's number came, and then they were like, wait, what do we do?
And they try and pass Kofi off onto Xavier, but he can't hold him up, and then Kofi just drops.
Yeah, there you go. There you go. Better than what they had where it was completely off camera. Or, like, they went out the entrance. They went to the entrance, and the next number started coming down and knocked him over.
Yeah, you can do that, too. That'd be perfect.
Like Jericho.
Especially if, like, it was an Uso, they came out and super kicked Big E, and they both fell, and then
right.
Kofi was eliminated.
An Uso or Jericho.
Dickhead Usos.
Yeah, if it was a different order, Jericho, of course, you know, something like that. But anyways, you have a DQ. Nah, X that one. Sorry,
what else are we
going
to say no to?
No managers or posses at ringside. They used to not allow them out there.
Yeah, they did that.
I can agree with that.
They did that with Curtis Axel. And the New Day.
Right.
That's
right.
True.
And Lana.
Well, yeah. No, Lana went to the back.
Lana went
to the back. That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm kind of with that.
I'm indifferent on that one.
I mean, the run-ins are one thing, but generally, like, a giant group hanging out, you know. The Wyatt thing was fine because they were eliminated and just kind of stuck around, you know, sneakily. I thought that worked. They weren't just hanging around. You're like, you knew somebody was going to get involved. Cause a crew, especially when we have all these all wrestler crews and they're more than just managers, can just yank somebody over. There's nothing you can do.
I like watching the older ones where you had like 3-4 managers out at ringside cheering for their guys.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's fine.
I miss those.
Yeah. I remember Heenan going down and then coming back up because his guy's next.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Coming back
yeah.
down with his other guy.
He just like did the laps up
yeah,
and down the aisle.
Jimmy Hart had different jackets for every single person.
He did. He completely did. No matter who was in the ring with him. That's great. That's it. I think I'm with that. But generally, I think
I'm with those five rules.
Which one?
Or did we do five or did just?
There's five.
Do we do the fifth one? I thought we did four.
No managers, can't lose by DQ. Anything touches outside the ring. Once you time it up, you have 10 seconds, and the time is a complete shoot.
Okay.
So
I agree with the time. I like the time being a complete shoot.
Yeah. This is Dan Velton of Figure Four Weekly to put this
that's
out
it.
There. Yeah, that's it. That's it. So
that's it.
I mean, interesting ideas. Good job, Dan. Nice try. But no. We like the Rumble mostly the way it is. Mostly.
Can we note just real quickly also in general Rumble talk from Sunday? That was a good, great show.
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
That was the best, like,
That was the best undercard I've seen in a while.
It was really good.
Yeah, top to bottom, I thought, you know, the weakest was the tag match, and it wasn't all that bad. The last man standing.
Kalisto Del Rio.
Yeah.
Kalisto Del Rio was a little.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Kalisto versus Moneybags, kind of.
Yeah, yeah, it seemed like something was off, down. Right? The Raw match was a lot better, of course. Yeah, you're right. I got them screwed up. But between the Last Man Standing and that Divas match, with the Sasha come out, perfect. Mm-hmm. Pitch perfect going into this. They got to that match, and I was like, geez, that was a main event. Like, in my mind...
The Sasha Becky and Charlotte thing was the main event before the Rumble.
That's why, in my mind, match wise, because that's where you would have put like the world title match or the WWE title match or something in years past, right?
Sorry, yeah. Do you know what was at that spot last year? That triple threat with Brock, Cena, and Rollins.
Exactly, and the year before was John Cena and Randy Orton that we completely shit on in Pittsburgh. Yes. And back when we went in 2000, and back when we went in 2008, it was Edge and Rey Mysterio. So, I mean, that kind of tells you, like, where that is. But, yeah. No, I think it was completely a great show. I think this is going to be a Royal Rumble we look back on as one of our favorites, like we do the 2008, the 1998, the 1992s, right? I wouldn't
put it up in 92.
No,
it's
wouldn't.
Not 92,
like, no. I'm saying it's in the league. Really, I'm not saying
nothing
it's
nothing is going to beat 92.
I think it's in the realm. Okay, in the top five, maybe in the top tens, whatever. You know, there's 30. That top 10 is going to be pretty full.
It's certainly better than a lot of. It's certainly better than the other one, Triple H one.
Yeah,
there you go. There you go.
But the Godfather returned and Mr. Perfect and all the people from the past.
I love that one. I love that one when there was like four people that came back like that, and I love the one where Diesel came back.
Well, and I think you mentioned it, and someone mentioned like this is the first Rumble in a long time where we didn't have like a nostalgia entrance, and I didn't mind it.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't miss it at all.
I thought Triple H was the nostalgia entrant.
Well,
no.
Yeah. But, I mean, he came out, he dominated just like 2002 and then did a lot of suck it chants.
Yeah, it's fine.
All right. On that note, let us know your thoughts on the Royal Rumble. Thank you, everybody in the chat room that's letting us know as well and talking about Impact.
Except Garza for saying fuck Kofi Kingston.
Oh, fuck yeah. Jerry Lawler. I mean,
that's not right.
Garza,
not
cool. You need a lesson in positivity, my friend.
Yeah, you do. Yeah, you do. All right. You know, hey, let's get positive. Let's get positive. Let's talk about some positive things happening, some positive stuff on the internet. If you don't like the Royal Rumble, if you're not liking what's happening on Monday nights, why don't you go check out indiewrestling.us? There's some good stuff over there, guys. There's some stuff like some best of Dalton Castle. There's death matches if you want to check that stuff out, including a Playtime is Over match that involves Legos.
Is Dana broken that match?
No, she is not. Videos, if you go to the indiewrestling.us YouTube page, there are actually clips of those matches up there. You can go check out Light Tube Jail Match, or whatever the hell they called it. There's Shane Douglas from RWA Season Beatings back in December. There's some great shows with Booker T, East versus West with New Japan Pro Wrestling and Border City Wrestling from Canada. Bret Hart's on those. IWC representing with the big winner takes all. If you didn't get a chance, they actually put, since the shows were canceled due to the great blizzard here in Pittsburgh this weekend, the winner takes all, the most critically acclaimed show of 2015 for the International Wrestling Cartel. And that's a show that didn't even have Tommy Dreamer and Rhino that were all over the rest of the year. And everybody's been talking about that show ever since about mid-December when that came out. You can check all those out. Individual match downloads for the RWA and the IWC. Great stuff from our friends at Vicious Outcast Wrestling. Hey, some young upstart named AJ Styles used to wrestle in Pittsburgh, I guess. And there's some best ofs. And there's the missing matches with AJ Styles with an exclusive interview that Joe Dombrowski did with him where he talks about it. This is right after he left TNA this last time. Before his odyssey that found him in New Japan Pro Wrestling and having killer matches in Ring of Honor with Matt Sydal, right on the brink of that. The same night that he had a match, an awesome match at Night of the Superstars in Meadville with Anthony Nice that just tore the house down. I've seen you nodding your head over there, Riz. You know about that stuff. Check it out, indiewrestling.us. A lot of people are up there. This is a guy called The Drifter. Used to be a Logan Shulo back in the IWC. You can check out matches with him. Taking on Sammy Callahan, who's just popping back up on the indie scenes. CM Punk is all over this stuff. Go check in a little bit of history. Who? Phil? Who's ending up on a lot of my shows recently. He was on Marin, and he was on another show he was mentioned too. I think Sirens.
I can't tell you because I'm blocked.
You're blocked by him? Yeah. Yeah, there's that too. You know what? We're gonna stick up for our friend Riz here.
Do it.
And I know some people. I've talked to some people in the Mayhem Show circle that have turned on CM Punk because he's blocked you. They're sticking up for you. But good. What better way than to buy a DVD that he's not getting a piece of? There you go, indiewrestling.us. Stick it to CM Punk. All right, we'll be right back. We're going to take a little look. What did we do last week? Last week was the guests, right? This is perfect for this week considering what just happened. If we had a Royal Rumble, a Mayhem Rumble, who would win? The answers.
Me.
The answers may surprise you. It could be the hype one. We'll be right back with a big question.
Not me. I mean, I don't want to use a weapon. It's more I could see Eamon just busting out a knife and just cutting Mad Mike in every orifice he has.
Steam Machine would emerge victorious from the Mayhem Show Royal Rumble because he has the most unbridled rage that I've ever seen on the show. And LB can get mad.
Me, by far. I'm a Hall of Famer, so I would win. Because I take after Edge, and I am the ultimate opportunist, so of course I would win. And I wouldn't be tired at the end either. And then afterwards, there would be a live sex celebration. Just like Edge.
I figure we've all hit each other enough with enough objects that it would just kind of be a draw. We would just kind of beat each other until we were all drunk and laying around on the mat.
I'm gonna say Wheels because everyone's gonna feel bad about throwing him out.
You really don't know this crew.
No.
One of the weekly features, of course. Chad probably said himself. So I'm gonna go with Dave. Doc Remedy.
Loki with a robo leg.
Riz would emerge victorious because he has had the most practice on the video game.
I would say me. I'm the wrestler of the year, technically. And I have a championship belt, and that's not what they can say, but that's what I can say.
I would say Doc Remedy, just from the fact that I don't know, I feel like he'd do anything he could to win.
I would say the winner of the Royal Rumble would probably be Missy Sorg, because she is a force of nature, and no one is going to fuck with her.
I would say Veronica. I got chopped in a line by everyone on the Mayhem Show. The one that I believe I still have a handprint under my Wrestling Mayhem Show t-shirt is from Veronica. And if she got anyone in a corner, one chop, they'd fly over the top rope.
Hey guys, it's the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Hope you guys are enjoying these clips we had from the 10-year anniversary. Big thanks to our friends Looking for Group for hosting that over in Brookline here in the South Hills of Pittsburgh. Check them out, lfgpgh.com. Good friends, and we hope to be doing some more fun stuff in the future with them. Nothing else, going down and playing with their virtual reality Oculus Rift stuff and watching Jen Carlin's get scared, and that's just fun. But anyways, so it is time for the big question. Mr. Lunchbox, you got a big question.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Mm.
So Sunday, a tiny dream came true for me. And that tiny dream was AJ Styles.
Mm-hmm.
I like AJ Styles. I enjoy his work. And from what I've seen in the past, and I'm glad that he can still go. He's still a talented wrestler, and it was very exciting to see him in my favorite wrestling event, the Royal Rumble. And then he started facing all these guys, and it's like, oh wow. The way I would compare it is when you get a new action figure, you have to make it fight all your other action figures just to see how it goes in your weird brain pan. And that's what it was like for me. It was like this new action figure. I get to see AJ Styles face off against all these guys. And it was a lot of fun for me. So my question to you guys is, who is your dream Royal Rumble entrant? Who for you would produce stand-up shouting excitement? This man is suddenly in the Royal Rumble, and he's facing all these wrestlers that you know so well, matchups that you never thought would happen. Who would get you that excited? Who is your dream Royal Rumble entrant?
I'll go. I mean, are we going kind of fantasy here or somebody active?
Fantasy?
No, active. Active? Ah.
Yeah.
Okay.
What was your fantasy?
So well, my fantasy say, yeah, was...
Let's do one of each. Let's do one, okay. One completely beyond the realm of possibility and one in reality.
My fantasy is, how many times, classically we went to Madison Square Garden and we saw John Cena come out when he was prognosed to be, several months out of being back, right? And, oh, geez, he's good to go, I thought he was injured. I thought he'd never come back, And I think the equivalent of that would be somehow, Stone Cold Steve Austin comes out. Whatever is wrong with him, they determine, okay, I can do this in such a way that I won't injure myself, right? And that happens. That's my miracle selection. Basically, when it comes to that, because I just Stone Cold seems like a guy that was taken away from us before he should have been. We should still have him popping up and doing like what Chris Jericho does, what The Rock does, even to an extent what Triple H does now. I just think there could have been so much more life in that. As far as a practical somebody out there, geez. Like, I kind of wish, the only one I can think of right now, because it feels like so much of this is kind of taken away, right? Like, AJ Styles, like, is there really anybody in TNA that you would have gotten as excited for as AJ Styles, right? And there's a few, yeah. But I don't know that much. I wish Matt Sydal, as he is now, would come back and kind of get the AJ Styles treatment.
As Matt Sydal, but not Evan Bourne.
Exactly. Because I think there's that bad connotation to Evan Bourne because he was like flippy jobber guy, right? And nothing really happened with him. And if he came back and he's just Matt Sydal. But we all know that would also mean that he's off the peyote and he probably won't be as much fun as he is now. So we know that probably won't happen, but realistically that I think that's the closest to my head that could. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I got some.
Okay.
For my fantasy, I was going to go with my favorite answer of all time, the great Khali, but that is probably out of nowhere, just me. But for fantasy, there was rumors about Shawn Michaels coming back. I would have liked to see him come back.
Mm-hmm.
Just for that little pop, that extra oomph of he could be in WrestleMania again. And as for the current, at this one, I'm juggling between two. But I'm going to lean towards a friend of the show, Dalton Castle.
Oh,
I'd love to see him in that ring against like Gold Dust, R-Truth, just the comedic effect of just having him in something that big and having seen him go from IWC where I started following him to WWE. Seeing how he's flourished into a gigantic character. It's awesome. And I would love to see that happen one day.
That'd be great. That'd be great.
I probably took somebody's answer, and I'm sorry.
No, you're good. The one I thought of that kind of comes to mind as far as like a signing or a debut or something like that that I would really love to see. Not to go off of the interview that we had last week that made the sheets, so to speak. But I would love to see Pentagon Jr. I think he is somebody who I'm extremely invested with as a character.
Call him by his right name.
Oh, what was it? Someone
junior
made it.
Junior Five Sides.
Junior Five Sides is his NXT name.
What?
But no, I would love to see that because of how amazing of a character he is. He's extremely marketable. His style of wrestling and how he could interact with so many people right now in the main roster. He's kind of become like a kind of cult hero right now in the wrestling world. I think that would be the one to go for.
All right. Eamon, your fantasy one.
Oh, fantasy? Sasha Banks, I don't know.
Damn it! That's good. Okay.
Damn it! That was.
I don't want to say fantasy because it's like, oh, it's a fantasy event. That makes it seem really weird.
Sasha Banks taking on 29 guys. Yeah. Anyways.
Guys named Eamon.
Oh.
I had my pin already and everything.
Oh, no. Hey, can I go on that note?
You made me pick a fantasy.
Did anybody else, I tweeted at this point, but did anybody else, like, saw the Sasha Banks, like, kind of pre-promo before the Royal Rumble on the network? And we're like, man, now everybody's going to think she's going to win the Rumble.
Oh, you mean like the network commercial?
The interstitial.
I always think Sasha Banks is going to win the Rumble.
Oh, yeah. She's going to be world champ one day. Mike, do you have a replacement to Sasha Banks?
My fantasy one, just because I think this would be amazing, Ricky Steamboat.
Yeah.
He's backstage.
Yeah.
Why not?
Yeah.
So is Pat Patterson.
Yeah, but
let's look at the last time Pat Patterson got into a ring and the last time Ricky Steamboat got into a ring, all right?
I know.
Like, Ricky Steamboat comes out and eliminates Chris Jericho. There. Mm-hmm. That's perfect. That's perfection for me. My realistic one, Ethan Carter. Naturally. And he comes out as Ethan Carter, and he's like a TNA defector, and he's
good. That is a better version of my Evan Bourne scenario. It really is.
Mm-hmm. Like, he doesn't come out as Derek Bateman. There's no USA guy. It's just like EC3. Trouble, and just the whole gimmick. Everything.
Man, I can't wait for WWE to buy them. Like, I feel like WWE would just do the invasion angle, but the right way with them. Yeah, somehow.
No, they wouldn't. They would buy them, and no one would notice.
They would buy them and grab like maybe four people from their roster.
It's like Facebook and Oculus Rift. You won't even know.
What? That was a weird. Okay. All four of you have been gone, right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Wait, LB.
What's up?
What's yours? And then I'll go to the newbies for tonight.
Well, AJ Styles was a big one.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just going to go ahead and say Samoa Joe. I've been a fan of his for years. I'd love to see him show up in the Rumble. And hey, that could happen. Mm-hmm. That's more likely now than it has ever been.
I thought it was going to happen.
I thought it could have happened on Sunday.
Yeah, me too.
Exactly.
I was pulling for it.
We'll have Samoa Joe show up in the Royal Rumble. And I don't know, Daniel Bryan will come back and they'll fight. And then I'll come like Starkiller Base blowing up five planets, and then I can never watch wrestling again. I know Daniel Bryan's never coming back, but I wanted to make the Starkiller Base reference. So, hey, fantasy pick, Daniel Bryan.
Wow. Perfect. Wow.
I was going to say, is your fantasy one Kylo Ren? Because...
All right, we have, if I have everything kind of set right, one, the big board has returned. And
Sorg, we have one from the chat room.
Wait. We have the people on the line I want to get to first, and we'll get to the chat room.
Gotcha, okay.
If you're on video, you're seeing those come up in the chat. We're throwing those up there as well. Matt Carlins is with us. He's got the big board in queue and also a big Power Ranger Zord behind him, protecting the big board as well. Oh, it lights up. That's nice. That's nice.
Yeah.
What's your Royal Rumble fantasy and realistic here?
Okay. I know people have their own opinions, but like for me personally, a fantasy Royal Rumble entry that would blow my mind would be Kurt Angle coming back. And I know not everyone is the biggest Kurt Angle guy, but if he came back and started dropping angle stands on everybody, and it wouldn't matter who's in the ring, it wouldn't matter Brock Lesnar's in the ring or Roman Reigns is in the ring, Angle would get in the ring and start whooping ass nonstop. There is no doubt in my mind. It would be an absolute demolition. It would be freaking awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm from Pittsburgh, so I'm biased. Let me see. A lot of you guys have taken my realistic pick. Junior Four Sides. I was definitely leaning that way. Was that what we were going to? Son of Four Sides? Four Sides?
Junior Five Sides.
Oh, that's right. Square Junior. That's what I was thinking of. Square Junior. Okay. That's Jesus. My fantasy pick is Square Junior. When Square Junior shows up in the Rumble, you guys are still with me? I thought that was kind of funny.
Who's Square Junior?
I don't know. I just made him up.
Oh, okay. All right. Fair.
You guys are all Googling it right now, aren't you?
Yeah.
All right. Okay, realistic one, Okada from New Japan. Jump in that ring. Rainmakers for everybody. That would kick ass. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And the damnedest drop kick on the face of the earth. That's all I need.
Now, Matt, are you just saying that because you want the Rainmaker and the Bullhammer to collide in like a Rocky II moment, or if they just explode in the ring?
That could work. That could be – that's a nice double knockout spot. And considering the way WWE sometimes treats the talent they bring in from the outside, I could legitimately see Okada and Wade Barrett being perceived as peers. So, yeah, it could work out okay for me.
Okay.
Main event in the Tokyo Dome. opening match on the main event in WWE.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
All right. And also with us, he's joining us from California. He's upgraded the internet. He's ready to go, and I'm trying to find where the heck I'm putting him tonight. He is Alex Kars, and we mentioned he's the designer of a lot of our stuff over at ProWrestlingTees.com/WMS, including what's that on your chest? Get that up above the title.
This is the Good Times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com.
Oh feature. Yeah,
good times.
Oh yeah, he's rocking it. He's joining us here for the Mayhem Mania. But do you have an answer to the big question, sir?
I do, actually. And it's funny because my two answers are both from the same company, outside of WWE, obviously. My realistic one, actually, I'll go with my fantasy one real quick first. My fantasy one would be Princess Kimberly with the Jakara Grand Championship in tow, walking down that ramp into the Royal Rumble.
I dig it.
I can see it.
Mm-hmm. I dig mm-hmm. it. Why not?
Princess Kimberly and Sasha Banks final two.
Yeah, there you go.
And, like, kind of going off the joke about invasion angles, a Chikara invasion would ensue. That's my kind of fantasy booking on that.
Okay.
My more realistic one is actually the first ever Chikara Grand Champion, Eddie Kingston, because he's the kind of guy who could probably fit quite well with WWE in general. I would love to see a program between him and Kevin Owens.
Oh.
Coming off of that.
I can see that.
There's a real big brawl fest all over the place. It'd be great. Kind of like what we got with the Last Man Standing between Ambrose and Owens on Sunday.
Awesome. All right, and from the chat room, we had a few selections. Miss Matt. No, that Matt gave that before. Garza says, similar to me, Daniel Bryan as number 30 as his fantasy, which not one of you guys mentioned. Realistic, Cassius O'Neil, Mr. Chris Hero, popping in there. That could be interesting. Bobby of J-Town, realistic or returning from injury early like Cena, Cesaro. Not possible, okay. Mil Muertes. There you go. So let's know what you think. Hashtag WMS big question. And let's know who do you want, fantasy and not so, in the Royal Rumble. So, Lunchbox.
Hey.
I know you got to bug out. I know you got really important panel ride business that you need to attend to right now, or whatever the case may be. Thank you so much for contributing the big question and hanging as usual.
Yes. Yeah. No problem. You're welcome. There is a panel riot business happening over at panelriot.com. Check it out at your earliest convenience. Follow us on Twitter at panel riot for all the dates and deets.
Awesome. Awesome. Now it's time. It's time for the Mayhem Mania. It is continuing. It is week three. The first round, the matches are out there. What do we do now?
Where are we at?
Somebody must have seen the board from before we got into this. Where's Dion? I don't know how I got there, but I guess someone was checking it out.
It looked like your handwriting, though.
Did not look like my handwriting. Well, sorry, how are we going to do this? All right, is Garza coming into play this week? I have to double check on that.
Oh, no. It's going to be Cars, Mike, Riz, and Eamon.
Cars, Mike, Riz, and Eamon.
Did I do that right? Did we do this right?
Yeah, but there's always room for more.
Okay.
Cars, Mike, Riz, Eamon.
Not me.
Remedy!
You're done. All right, four moves in. Here we go. All right, here we go. Mayhem Mania, building a better, a stronger, a faster WrestleMania card for you.
That's never happened.
Not necessarily predicting what WWE will do, but rather coming up with a card that would be even better. Coming up with the greatest WrestleMania card we could possibly come up with within the realms of reality. We cannot break free of the current status quo in professional wrestling industry. Long story short, we have to play by the same rules as Vince McMahon. We can't bring people over who are under contract to another company. We can't make people who are injured no longer be injured. We have to play by the rules. Now,
except Daniel Bryan, right?
As you'll see.
Well, Daniel Bryan is a special match.
We don't know. There is room for flexibility. There's always places to push the envelope. And what you might see is if someone pushes a little bit too hard, usually the population will speak up and they'll have to do something else. Anyway, we've got four guys. We're going to make four moves. We've got an 8-match card. Here in round three, we will not be creating any more matches out of thin air. 8 will be our cap until one of these matches graduates to the supercard. To do that, one of these matches must survive 3 weeks without being altered or molested in any way. So today, the four guys who are lined up, they will be able to make one move. Either they could swap one guy from one match to another. You could do one for one. So if you want Enzo to fight The Undertaker instead of Samoa Joe, you swap Enzo with The Undertaker, and it's Enzo versus Samoa Joe, and it's Undertaker and Big Cass in a tag team. or you could swap out a match entirely and bring an entirely new match with other guys. Or you can just simply add someone to a pre-existing match. So if you're desperate to see Dean Ambrose on here, no matter what, you just pop into one of these matches. Who cares? Whatever. Does that pretty much cover everything? The nice thing is that everybody here knows how to play. We've got the lineup ready to go. We've got four guys all lined up. Alex Kars will go first, Mad Mike is on deck.
Did you go through the matches as they are?
Let me go through the matches first. Alex, while you think about what your move is going to be, I will go through the matches. Thank you, Mike. Sword. Thank you, Sword. I'm very rattled, very nervous today.
You're very excited. You sound very excited.
I had a diet 7-Up before we came on, and I'm pretty hopped up right now.
I was going to say, Matt is under threat from his wife.
I know.
Every week, Dean Ambrose is not on this Mayhem.
I know. And look, the glass is empty. So, I mean, there's trouble right now. Here are the matches for Mayhem Mania thus far. This is awesome. Samoa Joe versus The Undertaker player. Tyler Breeze versus William Regal. Triple H and Mr. McMahon versus The Rock and Roman Reigns. Alberto Del Rio versus Finn Balor. The New Day versus Enzo and Big Cass. Kalisto versus Sami Zayn versus Neville. Kevin Owens versus Chris Jericho in a suit.
That's right. And
the Internet Jack-Off match presented by SureShot Reality. AJ Styles versus Daniel Bryan.
I think we should just put that in the match. That's in the supercard. That should be in the supercard. I'm just saying.
This match has to play by the rules just like everybody else. So let's wind this bad boy up. And Mr. Cars, let's see what you've got on your mind tonight.
Well, I've got a few things on my mind tonight. But the first thing I have is a question.
Okay.
How do stipulations come into play with this?
Stipulations, that's an excellent question. For those of you who watched last year, you'll recall that stipulations are something we will bring into the mix later. As we get closer to WrestleMania, we will have a special week where we will choose people to add stipulations to matches. So that will be coming down the line. So no pressure to add a stipulation to a match right now.
Oh, that's a shame because I had some. Okay.
Now you can make – now if you want to make a match and just kind of like suggest a stipulation that you think would be awesome to throw in there, feel free to suggest. But I'm not – it's not going to go in your match.
Nope,
it's always good to suggest. It's always good to give people an idea of where your mind is going, you know?
Okay. All right. So for my move, I'm going to this is a toughie.
It's a toughie.
Somehow tougher than last year. I remember last year.
I remember too.
Let's see.
While Alex is thinking this over, remind everyone to go to WrestlingMayhemShow.com and read the recaps from the first 2 weeks, and you can actually go back and see all the calamity we caused a year ago, which is pretty amazing. If you watch some of those old videos, they are fantastic.
Okay, I've got my move.
Okay.
I am going to switch out. That's right. Did you say that we can switch? We can only switch wrestlers that are already on the card, right? If we're swapping?
If you want to use a guy that's on the card, you got to swap him out of the match.
Oh, that's right.
If he's not on the card, you can add
someone new, right?
Yeah, to a match? You can basically add someone into a match.
Okay, now I've got my move. I am going to add to the Del Rio versus Balor match, I am going to add El Torito. And here is why. I remember watching ADR versus Kalisto the other week on SmackDown, and Mr. Jerry Lawler decided that he needed to make short person jokes the whole time because he's trying to be a heel now. I want to see the uncomfortableness of everybody else when he starts making those jokes about El Torito. Because it's one thing when it's JBL doing it on Raw. This is Jerry Lawler we're talking about SmackDown. And there's a good chance he might be on pay-per-view.
The classy of the two gentlemen.
So, right, that's my move.
Well, it just wouldn't be Mayhem Mania without El Torito on the card. So good job, Alex.
And then another.
Mad Mike, you're up, and Riz is on deck.
All right. I feel bad because I'm going to swap out a match entirely.
Oh no!
Yeah.
The match I had picked before Alex even said anything was Balor versus Del Rio, because I don't want to see a battle of Big Stomp versus Little Stomp.
Don't you do it, Mike?
Oh no, I'm doing it. That match is gone.
Oh no!
That match is gone, folks.
I'm not talking to you anymore, Matt.
That match is gone. No, Alex, I think you'll appreciate what I'm going to do here.
You're
going to
put El Torito on that one, too.
Yes.
We'll see. You're not going to do
we'll
it.
We'll see. We'll see.
This is what happened last year.
No. That is not what I'm doing.
It's like every year we have to have the we'll see match.
At least for a week.
Matt, we are having a fatal four-way.
Oh.
Are we now?
Yes, we are. that fatal four-way
go on,
is going to involve some competitors that we have not mentioned. That'll be Sasha Banks, Char Char, Bayley, and Becky Lynch.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. Wow.
Okay. The real diva of the revolution.
Okay.
I can accept that.
And yes, I have to say Char Char.
You do.
Of course you do. You have to. Shasha and Char Char.
Jeez. All right, there you go. Who did I say was next? Riz.
Me.
Riz, you're up. Eamon's on deck.
This better be a very hype match.
So I got another question for you, sir.
Yeah.
If we take off a match, are we allowed to use a wrestler from that match?
No.
I don't think so. I mean, why not just swap out one guy and bring in another guy?
That's true, too. That is
because
true.
I'm doing something a lot different than that.
Should we let him propose it and we can make a rolling?
Sure.
I thought the rule always was if you're swapping a match completely, you have to use people who aren't.
You gotta do a match,
but they're not going to be on the board anymore.
Well, you could try to you could slowly build it. I mean, if you're going to do a multi-man match, you can take one guy out, add the guy this week, come back next week, try to add another guy. Okay.
All right. So
I don't think I can let you swap and then reuse. We can't do that.
All right. So actually, then I'm going to add. I can't see up there. Who's Regal facing again? I probably.
Oh, that'd be Tyler Breeze.
Tyler Breeze. Let's do. I actually have it on my Slack. So while I'm thinking, please talk.
Yes.
Oh, good.
By the way, we should mention
the action so far.
We should mention that the Samoa Joe Undertaker match was brought to you by none other than. Friend of the show,
Krista
Joseph.
Yes, last week, if you were with us last week, you saw us kind of not sure if Krista Joseph was getting this, but once the rules clicked into place, a millisecond later, Krista Joseph spit out this match. He's like some sort of booking supercomputer.
Oh yeah,
right? He's like the Deep Blue of WrestleMania fantasy booking. You just gave him the boundaries, and he was like, "Oh, Samoa Joe versus the Undertaker." We're like, "Perfect."
Should we add a brought to you by Lucha Underground to that match?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
That should be the title sponsor a little bit.
Because if we're doing that for LaBar's thing, then...
It all depends on whether Garza can Photoshop the little logo into the bottom of the Chex-Mix logo.
All right. So, I'm going to get rid of the... sorry, Sorg. The Kevin Owens Chris Jericho match?
No! Keep the suit. Can you keep the suit?
Completely.
Kevin Owens deserves better than that.
He's in a suit. Dude, do you know how good that looks in a WrestleMania graphic?
First of all, the best Chris Jericho is the top ponytail Chris Jericho, and that's a fact.
But suit Jericho would be a close second.
I'm not hating your opinion. I just got to say, I'm not hating.
Yeah. But... What I'm going to do is I'm going to please Jen Carlin's on this one.
Uh-oh.
Wait, what?
Let it happen.
I'm putting Dean Ambrose in a match.
That's very nice of you.
Against El Torito.
I wish.
Against Drake, the NXT referee. Okay.
That would actually be pretty good.
Hey, Drake. Hey, let's see Drake. Drake Younger could probably still go.
But I want Dean Ambrose against Luke Harper.
Ooh. Luke Harper.
Okay.
Not new.
In a suit.
What?
I'll get Garza on that right away.
Do it in this.
I argue that's not the realm of possibility.
Corporate Harper.
The suit is optional for
now,
men.
Is the suit nothing but gator leather? Because it should be.
No, the suit is just the wife beater and a tie.
I think Garza is going to hate
you for
the photo.
Isn't that just what Jericho
wore
last week?
Pretty much.
No, he wore a vest and nothing else.
Jericho's bit is that he no longer owns shirts.
Yes. Did you really write down he's wearing a suit?
Yeah, I'm going to see if Garza can do it. That and sponsorship logos. Like, coming
he says,
soon.
Wait, from the chat, he says, I am not photoshopping Harper in a suit. Listen, man.
Okay, at least put Dean in a suit.
At least a really nice leather.
Listen, just get the Jericho in the suit.
Or at least put him in a tie.
Well, that's we have we pictures of Dean in a suit. When
I want Luke yes. Harper in a with a bow tie. That's all I want.
Yeah, Luke Harper in like the wife beater and the dirty ripped up vest and a tie.
While we're giving him
like,
trouble,
like the dicks, the dicks.
Oh God,
like that tie.
While we're giving him trouble and give him a Photoshop heart attack, shout outs to Tonio Garza.
By the way, just this one time. After whoever else goes, can I get a redo on my turn?
No, you can't.
I tell you what. Since you asked so nice, maybe we'll invite you back for next week.
Oh.
Since it is pretty cruel I'm making a rule right here because
what happened last year is I made a match and the next turn gone.
Yeah, I know. And you know what? I feel bad. You have elicited pity from me, which is not easy to do. But I'm going to tell you what we're going to do, all right? Because this happened last year a couple times, and it was kind of like tough deal with it. But I'll tell you something. If you create a match in Mayhem Mania and it gets obliterated before the end of the round in its entirety, if it gets entirely gone, if your match gets entirely blown off the board, we will invite you back next week, guaranteed. You will get a guaranteed spot next week.
Should we put him last?
You will have a unique opportunity next week to come back and back cleanup so that your change next week cannot be undone. So at least it will live for 1 week, Alex. El Torito will run wild for 1 week.
You're going to put him in that match, aren't you? You're going to put him in my match, aren't you?
I had a completely different idea.
Put El Torito into one of these matches, you kill it.
Mm-hmm.
You inject El Torito into a match. It's a like a lethal dose. Mike, it's like a lethal dose.
Of poison! There we go.
Cut!
Yeah. I thought we had the WLC for a while.
WLC was on the final card.
Yeah,
it was part of the selection for the last.
It would have been amazing at WrestleMania.
WLC. That's what that was.
Man, I just like and the, I was, the thought.
I was fearful that it was going to make it.
The thought of 80,000 people watching a tiny ring with even tinier people wrestling in it. It just is amazing.
It is
well,
amazing.
Well, wasn't the WLC match last year like Cesaro versus
Sheamus? Cesaro versus Sheamus in a WLC match.
Tiny tables, tiny chairs.
Oh, yeah.
Giant, hulking European men. Where are we? Eamon?
Yeah, that got weird.
Time to wrap it up, Eamon.
Moving on, that got weird.
Okay.
Wrapping it up. Bring it home.
Last question, because I know we got a lot of questions. So if there's a multi-person match on this card, can I switch two people or can I only switch one?
You can only swap one person at a time.
Okay.
Unless we're talking about a tag team, you can swap tag team for tag team.
Okay, yeah. But no, that's not the case. The three-way match with Kalisto, Zayn, and Neville. Swap out Kalisto for Kevin Owens.
Ooh.
All righty, there you go. Good job, E.
Okay. Quick, suffice, to the point. I knew what I wanted.
There you go.
Owens can't stand to be off this card for more than 5 minutes. All right, good job, boys. Sorg, are we going to have a run-in? Do we have a fifth guy? Anybody else want to get on this?
No, it's just going to be those guys, if that's all right.
All right, good job. We're going to stop it at four. I think next week maybe we'll try to do five people next week.
Oh, crazy. You're insane.
To bring back Alex to be the final pick.
That's true.
We'll have four more people. I don't want to deprive the other four people that you have scheduled. I know you've booked four more people for next week, right?
Now watch Alex
totally
obliterate one match that was made.
it's gonna be vengeful. All right, so here we go. Here's the ones that survived this week. Samoa Joe versus The Undertaker. Tyler Breeze versus William Regal. It lives! Triple H and Mr. McMahon versus The Rock and Roman Reigns. The New Day versus Enzo and Big Cass. And, of course, AJ Styles versus Daniel Bryan. And newly created now, we have Sasha versus Char versus Becky versus Bayley. We've got Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn versus Neville. And we've got Dean Ambrose versus Luke Harper in a suit. Right.
There we go.
In a suit. God willing. Come on, Garza. You can do it.
I have faith.
Luke's going to go to the spa. He's going to get his hair done.
His beard trim.
Hair did.
He's going to be in a ponytail like Daniel Bryan that one
week. Yeah. He looked like Mick Foley when he got done.
Yeah. Okay. Back to you, Sorg.
All righty. With that, let's head over to talk about what you learned from wrestling this week. Who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Oh, he got it.
Yeah. I learned from wrestling this week that sometimes the best moments in wrestling are the ones that people don't prepare to happen. For example, Bo Ryda absolutely schooling an actual rapper.
I mean, that's something that goes on his resume. Is that on his Wikipedia by now as accomplishments in pro wrestling?
It should be.
It should be. Yeah.
And Flo Rida should be absolutely ashamed.
That's why
Rick Ross left early.
Yeah,
this
exactly.
Man gets paid to do that thing.
Yeah.
This man, people pay money to attend concerts to see him do that thing.
Mm-hmm. Certainly. Yeah, certainly. What about you, Mad Mike?
Sorg, I learned that I can watch almost an entire marathon of Lucha Underground and still not properly be prepared for Lucha Underground season 2.
Tomorrow night, please tell me you guys are watching that live and live tweeting.
I can't watch it live because I'm going to be at work.
Somebody needs to step up.
I'm not entering the internet at all as soon as I get home.
Oh.
I'm not even watching Arrow. I'm not saying hi to my mother. I'm just going to watch Lucha Underground immediately.
I imagine this scene where Mike, Mom, I'm home. Oh my God, man, Mike, did you see what happened? It was.
Yes, my mother is going to spoil Lucha Underground for me, and I'm going to be very upset.
No more taste, lit someone on fire.
Friends don't let friends spoil Lucha Underground.
Okay, I got one.
All right. Mr. Riz, you have the floor.
I have the hype floor, Sorg.
Hype it.
I learned that wrestlers hate a certain fan more than we do.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If you haven't seen Big E's Twitter account lately, it is on fire.
Okay.
And he hates Rick the Sign Guy.
Wait, because didn't Owen start yelling, "I hate you, sign guy," at some point as well?
Yes. Yeah.
Basically, Kevin Owens and Big E destroy Twitter.
They are what heels are supposed to be on Twitter. Let's see. The biggest mistake I made tonight was mentioning sign guy on TV. I'm sure he'll loop that moment on Vine and touch himself to it.
Oh man,
that was good. Not inaccurate.
Nope.
No,
probably not. Yeah,
that's what I learned. Sir.
What about you, Matt Carlin's on your phone?
Yes.
Hey, I'm in high level negotiations with our friend, our Patreon friend Antonio Garza, to Photoshop Luke Harper in a goddamn swamp suit. So. Don't question me, Sorg. I'm doing important things. All right, this might be a little bit off the radar. Med Mike, just cover your ears because I'm going to spoil Impact real quick. I learned from wrestling this week that if you need a babysitter and you're in a pinch, Tyrus is a decent option. He is very caring with the baby. He carried Baby Hardy to the ring tonight on Impact. And he was very nurturing and careful. And you know what? I would trust my children with Tyrus. He looks like he could do the job. So wrestler / nanny, Tyrus, you got a backup career now, buddy. Good for you.
He's like,
you're good, Mike. Go ahead, put your headphones back.
Come on back, Mike. He was singing. He took his headphones off. He was kind of singing and doing a lot of himself or something. I'm glad that we can come to an agreement on these sorts of things. So
as long as I'm warned.
Yes, exactly.
Damn it, I hate Impact as much as it is. I don't want to be spoiled for it, so I have something shitty to look forward
to. It is
to.
So interesting.
There's one thing that ruins the awfulness of Impact, it's knowing it's coming ahead of time. It's better to be surprised.
It's like when you first realize you have food poisoning.
And you're not.
I'm not joking.
This is just the stomach flu.
I got food poisoning once 2 years ago, and as soon as I realized it, I'm like, oh, it's a horrible night ahead of me, isn't it? it's just not, like, because I'm going to go downstairs. I'm going to be honest. I'm not going to watch Impact right away. Go watch Total Divas. I'm going to watch Flash. Go watch Legends of Tomorrow. I'm going to watch Agent Carter. I'm going to watch a bunch of things. And then when I've had my fill of good entertainment, then I'm going to watch Impact because I feel like having a shit sandwich for dessert. And I just don't want to know what's coming.
Yeah, eat that sandwich.
Yeah.
Eat that food.
Eat that Impact.
Oh, we will.
And that is quote of the night that I just tweeted out.
Now we get back spoilers. It's like realizing you have food.
Spoilers from Impact, I put in quotes that you know you have to watch later, is like the first moment you notice that you got food poisoning. Mad Mike. Alex Cars, I do not challenge you to come up with something as thoughtful as that because... That's a tough hill to climb.
I already had something in mind for that. It's like if the Titanic happened in the middle of the day instead of at night, and they saw the iceberg coming.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, I learned that I can't have nice things.
Nope.
Including El Torito on the WrestleMania card, but. I learned that, you know what? That's about it. I can't think of anything else.
Okay. I'm very sorry about that.
That's fine. Hey, that's fine.
Oh, actually, kind of as a I know how Mad Mike feels about not getting to really watch Lucha Underground because tomorrow I literally go back up the mountain to go back to work and stuff. So
oh, no.
There's like no cable, no. Like, I barely get internet access.
He becomes the mountain man. Oh,
I literally have not watched much wrestling in 2 or 3 weeks.
Jeez.
So.
We got to figure out a way to, like, load all the wrestling for a week on a thumb drive and mail it to him or something.
That is the correct answer.
That's what needs to happen. We'll work on that. Don't get eaten by a bear, please, in the meantime. Okay, from the chat, Bobby F. J-Town learned that Ride Along is the new table for three. Ron Funchin's got a shout-out, and Big E is super flexible. Wow. Also, what we need to be more positive about wrestling because awesome shit is happening all around us. Garza, something I actually barely learned, Matt Hardy and Jeff Hardy are not using the same song.
This is true.
Okay.
They're still both using shitty, shitty songs, though.
Okay. That I guess so. From the Facebook group, we asked the same question. And over there, we had our friend of the show, Chris LaRusso, wrestler for Ring of Honor, IWC, and other promotions all around. He loves fan reactions to debuts. And there's like a fan reaction video to AJ Styles coming out that looks pretty fantastic. And he says, warning if you have headphones on the volume on this one. So go check that out on the Facebook Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook group. We got a lot of great stuff going on there. There are a few other notices on there. Kyle in there says that unicorn horns are actually detached llama penises.
You can't say penises, or
apparently
you can't say penises. Penis. You are confusing your mythical animals.
I apparently am. Wheels learns that being a promoter isn't an easy job, and some care about people. And he ate snow. Yeah, both RWA and IWC here in the Pittsburgh area got canceled this weekend. Big shows for both. 7th anniversary for the Renegade Wrestling Alliance. 1 year with Justin Plummer with IWC, International Wrestling Cartel, and Billy Gunn was supposed to be a part of the show as well. Both getting rescheduled to some degree. So stay tuned to rwalive.com, iwcwrestling.com for info on that as it comes up. What else we got? Kyle says... January 24th, 2016 will forever be known as the day the world marked out. That's a good one. Daniel on there says that AJ fits everyone's style. Okay. I like that. I like that.
See it.
Good. Good.
High marks from
also,
the crew.
Also, Sorg, Ride Along is amazing.
I know. I need to catch up. I need to watch 24 as well.
I'm saddened it's only 20 minutes long.
Oh, geez.
If you had seen the soft pilot for Ride Along, which was that random episode of Total Divas, you already knew it was going to be awesome.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
And finally, Rick on here says it's apparently time to play the game again. So, as we talked about much earlier in the show.
It's all about the game and how you play it.
There you go.
It's all about the game and the fact
that
you
can lost. Well, here's the thing.
Guys, it's been the Wrestling Mayhem Show. Thank you so much, everybody.
Sorg, did you say what you learned?
Oh.
What did you learn this week, Sorg?
Did you learn anything, Sorg?
What did you learn, Sorg?
Oh.
What did you learn, Sorg?
Oh.
Stay hype and know what you learned, Sorg.
Oh. I feel like
your turn, Sorg.
I feel like Renee Young is really trying to avoid Jerry Lawler on those pre-shows.
I feel like everyone should try to avoid Jerry Lawler.
There you go.
The man was 2 for 2 in predictions.
I guess he was.
I would be too if I read the fucking script.
Mm-hmm.
That's
mm-hmm.
what he probably did too. Like fucking Jack Swagger and Mark Henry are going to win the thing.
In fairness,
surprise.
And I'm a witness, I predicted Jack Swagger and Mark Henry were going to win that match too. Dang it, Alex Cars.
I did too.
Yes. He was also one of two people to correctly predict that Triple H was going to win the Rumble.
One of only two people. Who are all of you idiots who didn't know Triple H was winning that? I can't even. All right.
No, they just didn't play the league. That's it.
That's right.
Guys, thank you so much.
The views and opinions of Matt Carlin's are not the views and opinions of anybody here on the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
No.
We do not think you guys are idiots.
My opinions are right.
No. Guys, thank you so much for joining us. Of course, shouts to DJ Lunchbox on the Twitter, panelriot.com. You dropped out a little earlier after the big question. Hey, the Mayhemmies are going on right now. WrestlingMayhemShow.com. We have these videos over there. We sat down with Justin Plummer, promoter for the International Wrestling Cartel, Joe Dombrowski, announcer and producer on such hits as Finding Zach Gowen and the Montreal Theory, Chris LaRusso, we talked about earlier, of course, a 10-year veteran in pro wrestling, and about what they thought was the big stuff for the year. Who should be nominated on for the year for best wrestler, best female wrestler, best tag team. Go check out all the videos and get your votes in as well. WrestlingMayhemShow.com. These videos hosted by the great Papa Lunchbox, and we have some other selections on there as well as the best interview from Indy Mayhem Show. We talked to so many people this past year, some great names in the industry, and introducing you to some new ones, and best host, Patreon fan of the year, and a lot of fun stuff. Thank you. A bunch of people have already getting their votes in, and it's very, very hype, Riz. It's very, very hype.
Sorg, can I make an impassioned plea on behalf of a Mayhemmy?
Okay.
Okay. Fans and friends of the Wrestling Mayhem Show, this is Mad Mike. Hi. Hi. We have a Mayhemmy for non-wrestling personality of the year. Now, I was not in the room when these nominees were decreed, but I feel as a duly appointed representative of the Midweek War, I implore everyone watching this, everyone within the sound of my voice, to write in Dario Cueto, the owner and proprietor of Lucha Underground, for non-wrestling personality of the year. Because when Dario Cueto wins this prestigious award, we need an acceptance speech from him. We need this in our lives, guys. You can make this happen. I've been Mad Mike, and I support this message.
There you go. Get your votes in. We're going to close the voting probably this weekend. And the Mayhemmies presentation, guys, get your suits ready. Get your suits ready. The Mayhemmies presentation, awards presentation, will be next week, next Tuesday, February 2nd, We're going to see how that goes. The voting is...
That's right, Luke Harper. Get your suit to the dry cleaners.
That's right.
Get it ready for next Thursday, buddy.
That's right. And already I'm taking a peek.
Swamp casual, business swamp casual will not suffice.
I'm taking a peek, and it looks like a pretty dead heat between a couple people for Wrestling Mayhem Show, host of the year, and Runaway Train, perhaps, for interview guest of the year for Indie Mayhem Show. And, wow, some of these other ones are getting really interesting for non-wrestling personality as well. And, a few for Cueto. Wow. Mike?
Yeah?
He's got to fight some of those other guys on the list, but Cueto got a few in there.
Good.
So already
because I saw he wasn't up for it. Mm-hmm. I voted for Dario Cueto. Mm-hmm. I immediately commented, everyone needs to vote for Dario Cueto.
Yeah. Push it. Get it out there. Let the people know. Mad Mike 4883 on the Twitters. Doing all kinds of fun stuff, including the midweek.
Total Divas
war.
Wrap-up coming tomorrow,
Total
bitches.
Total Divas wrap-up, of course. Matt Collins, Mainstream Matt, getting shout-outs by one Jim Loke on Awesome Cast tonight.
I'm going to have to go watch that now.
Towards the beginning, you don't have to get far. Okay. Awesome Cast actually going to start streaming this week on the RiversEdgePGH.com, a 24-hour streaming station on the interwebs out of Millville,
nice.
PA over here. So go check
About
that
time.
Out as well. About time. Get it out there. Riz,
yeah.
Riz plays games on the Twitter.
Yes.
Go check it out.
It's the new hot thing right now. So.
It is. It is. Alex Cars, he's got stuff going on.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Later this week, I'm going to be recording two sessions on our Chikara in 15 minutes or less. I'm recording the return of Chikara 15 in time for the Chikara 16, the season 16 premiere at the end of this month. I'm also recording the Chikara 101 season 15 awards. The awards were voted on by the 101 forums throughout the last couple weeks, and I'm getting a chance to record the results of those of that voting.
Awesome. Awesome. Go check it out. Of course, everything going on at SorgatronMedia.com, WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Subscribe to the show. All the links at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Drop us a line, 412-206-WMS0 or Good Times.
Good Times.
Good Times at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. Streaming at the 405media.com. Thank you so much for everybody joining us. Mayhem out. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.